الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the world. I bear witness there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad is messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace be upon him. My dear brother and sister in Islam, I advise myself first and I advise all of you to establish the fear of Allah in your deepest of the heart and translate into your daily life. And I would like to image that your neighbor has been a servant, and his servant asking your neighbor to provide for him a house and fancy car and large TV. So generally speaking, what do you think about that? The servant should just get his money at the end of the month or at the end of the week, then go. But what about the servant if he's asking your neighbor about a house or about a car, fancy car or whatever? And you can't image that your neighbor is give this servant whatever he asked. Also, he asked him, whatever you need, if you need more items, just tell me, and I'm willing to provide them to you. It's amazing, absolutely. So our khutbah today about the supplication, about dua, and how is the dua is important in our life. How is the dua is important in our aqeedah. Allahu yaghdabu in tarakta su'alahu. Wa bunayya adama hina yus'alu yaghdabu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to be asked. Allah is get angry when you do not ask him. And the human gets angry when you ask him. So you can't compare between them. Allah gets angry when you do not ask him. And the human gets angry when you ask them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Ghafir, ayat 60, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Allah said, O my slave, believe in me and asking me, and I'm willing to provide whatever you're asking me. Also, there is another hadith which is more than important, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that الدعاء هو العبادة. The supplication, the dua is the worship. Why? The question is, why the supplication is important in our Islam, in our Iman? There is a lot of reason, but the main reason is that you have to believe no one can help you except Allah. You have to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your weakness, how you are weak, and how you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help. This is the main thing of Iman. No one around the world can help you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, some people believe in their ability or believe in people more than Allah. How is that working? For example, some people believe in their salary at the end of the month, so I will not ask Allah for rizq. I will not ask Allah for food, because at the end I will get myself. This is the main thing. And you can't image that. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said you have to ask Allah for everything. His companies mentioned that we ask Allah even for our salt, our sugar, and for everything. Allah mentioned ayah, I believe this ayah is warm, and we have to believe that this ayah, there is no excuse for you. Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. The interpretation of this meaning is that, oh Muhammad, of my slave asking about me. Oh Muhammad, of my slave asking about me, tell them, I'm near to them by my knowledge, and I'm willing to accept their supplication, and I'm willing to provide their dua. So ask them to believe in me. That's all. Of my slave asking about me, tell them I'm near to them by my knowledge, and I'm willing to accept their supplication. Subhanallah. Unfortunately, some people, when they get sick or when they need something, they're just looking for a human or for a new device to fix their problem. I will tell you one story. It's happened to one person. I know him by his eyes. 2 years ago, he got cancer. And as you know, cancer is kind of disease, it's not easy to recover. Then he went around the world, like Germany and over there in Boston, to find treatment. At the end, he moved from Boston to Riyadh. Then in the same time, in the airport, he changed his flight from Riyadh to be in Jeddah in order to go to Mecca. In the same time, when he reached Jeddah, his son told me that. And I saw this person 3 times. When he went to Jeddah, he just wear ihram. Then he went to Mecca. Then he practiced his supplication and the dua. And stay, his son told me that my father stay and make sujood from the Kaaba more than 4 hours. He's in sujood. Then asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the deepest of his heart to accept and to recover and give him heal from the cancer. But do you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the most generous, will reject his dua? Allah accepted his dua. Then he went to hospital. They say the cancer is gone. We have to believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the cancer. Easy. Then Allah gave the cancer. That's all. I will tell you one hadith. It's narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala an, and it is in At-Tirmidhi and Abu Dawud and Ibn Majah. Inna Allah hayyun kareem. Inna Allah hayyun kareem. يستحي إذا رفع الرجل يديه يستحي إذا رفع الرجل يديه أن يردهما خائبتين. Allah is the most generous and shy. Please listen to the hadith carefully. Allah is the most generous and shy when his slave raises his hand and asking Allah. Allah becomes shy to return his hand empty. Subhanallah. Allah becomes shy to return his slave hand is empty. So that problem is because of us, because of our iman, because of our heart. That's all. And there is another hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala in Ibn Majah, and now our Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned that there is no thing greater than dua, greater than supplication. But some people say that we make dua, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not accept my supplication. As you know, everything has rules. So what is the rules of our supplication? If you breach the rules of our supplication, this is because of you. This is because of you. I will tell you, just four rules, the most important rules in your supplication in order to accept Allah, in order to accept your supplication. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that, ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ الرَّجُلُ يُطِيلُ السَّفَرَ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَى يمد يديه إلى السماء ويقول يا رب يا رب يا رب ومطعمه حرام ومشربه حرام وملبسه حرام وغذي بالحرام أنى يستجاب له. The interpretation of this meaning is that a person who has long travel distance, then he stopped, then he raised his hand, then he mentioned 3 times, Ya Rab, Oh my Lord, Oh my Lord, Oh my Lord. But his food is haram, is prohibited. And his drink is haram. And his cloth is haram. And he used to feeding by haram. How Allah will accept his supplication? How Allah will accept his supplication? You can't, you know, there is an important point of this hadith when our Prophet ﷺ mentioned that after long distance. Do you know why? Because when you are traveling for long distance, then you stop, that means you show Allah your weakness. you show Allah how I need my, your help, Allah. And you said three times, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. But the problem is because of you. You are eating haram, drink haram, wear haram. So how Allah will accept your supplication? And there is another ayah. Do you know that Allah accepts the supplication and dua from non-Muslim? If non-Muslim asking Allah from the deepest of their heart, Allah will accept their supplication. So about human. But the thing is, you have to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to believe that Allah will accept your supplication. Ud'u Allah, and our Prophet Muhammad mentioned that, ud'u Allah wa antum muqinoon bil ijaba. Make supplication. Before you make supplication, you have to believe Allah will accept. Allah will provide what you ask.